water is an essential commodity for all living organisms. To make it available to every user, management of water is a must. For best utilization of water resources, various multipurpose projects are in use. These projects include irrigation, flood control, power generation, and navigation. For these purposes, a correct and accurate assessment of water availability in time and space and methods of efficient use of water are very important from both technical and economic points of view. The demand for accurate assessment of water resources is increasing with increase in population. The flow measurements are also necessary for sharing waters between different states or countries, and also for distribution between different headworks and canals. Therefore, reliable and standard measurements of water flow or discharge in rivers and other open channels are of vital importance. To measure the discharge, area velocity method is commonly used. In this method, area of the flow section and the average velocity of the flow are determined at a particular location. The discharge is equal to the product of these quantities. This method is based on the principle of continuity. For this area velocity method, a location is identified, keeping in view that there should be an adequate straight reach having streamlined flow. It means location should be away from curves and there should be no turbulence. The site should also be away from any large structure which may affect the flow pattern. Stream bed should be stable and free of large deposits and weeds. This location under the bridge, away from the curve, having straight reach, is an ideal location for discharge measurement in this canal. Similarly, it is a good location in the river, and here measurement can be made by the boat. When velocities are excessive, or when the riverbed is irregular in mountainous regions, a trolley is used along a wire drawn between the two banks. To know the area of the cross-section, width and depth are to be measured. The depth of the channel bed may vary along the width of the channel or river. Therefore, the stream is divided into a number of observation verticals in such a way that the discharge between two consecutive verticals should be less than 10% of the total flow. The spacing between the verticals is reduced if the bed profile changes greatly across the river, though it is convenient to make the verticals equidistant. For measuring the distance of the verticals from the bank, rope and tacks are used. When the river is too wide and deep, the method of triangulation is used to establish the verticals. For this purpose, the property of similar triangles is used. This distance corresponds to river width, and it can be divided into desired number of verticals. At sight, the boat is brought on a cross line perpendicular to the river flow with the help of a pair of poles. Now the ranging is done to bring the boat at the desired vertical. Theodolite is also used to establish the verticals. After establishing the verticals, the depth is measured. The sounding rods are used to measure the depth. where bed is not too deep. In deep channels, depth may be measured by metered cable to which a heavy weight is attached. Another reliable device is the echo sounder. It measures the time taken by the sound waves in going to the bottom and coming back to the receiver. Echo sounder is so sensitive that it can measure the time difference of 1 upon 400th of a second. Once the depth is measured, the next step is to measure the average velocity in each vertical of the channel. To do so, current meter is used. This is a cup type current meter, very common in use when current velocity is high. This vertical axis meter can prevent sediment laden water from entering the bearings. But in addition to the horizontal velocity, it will also measure the vertical component of velocity. This is a propeller type current meter. This is better suited to measure horizontal velocity. But its blades can be damaged by abrasion. This current meter, smaller in size, is used to measure low velocities. To measure the velocity in very small discharges and in laboratory work, the digital low-speed probe current meter is used, which gives velocity directly. In all the current meters, electric current is passed to the wheel, which on rotation, due to flowing water, makes and breaks a contact and produces the ticks and clicks sound, which is heard by the observer through headphones. Suppose the number of revolutions per second worked out to be n, then velocity v will be a plus bn, where a is the starting velocity to overcome friction and b is a constant of calibration. The meter is calibrated periodically. To measure the velocity in shallow waters, the current meter is supported on a graduated wading rod, which rests on the bed of the stream. For measurement in deep water, the meter cable is suspended by a cable and a heavy weight at the bottom that keeps the meter cable as near the vertical as possible. The heavy weight is a streamlined body which has the shape of a fish and has fins. But at high velocities, the meter cable and weight may not be vertical below the point of suspension. Correction is to be made to obtain the correct depth. In general, the stream velocity varies approximately as a parabola, from zero at the channel bottom to a maximum at the water surface. It has been established that the average of the velocities measured at 2/10 and 8/10 depth below the surface is a measure of the mean velocity in the vertical. The velocity at 6/10 depth below the surface is also a good measure of the mean velocity in the vertical. Therefore, after finding the total depth in a vertical, the current meter is then fixed at desired depth and the number of impulses counted in a time of about 1 to 2 minutes. From the elapsed time and the calibration of the meter, the mean velocity is found. The average velocity along a vertical multiplied by the area of the vertical section gives the incremental discharge in that vertical section. The sum of such incremental discharges gives the total discharge. When velocities are excessive and the rivers are too wide, the use of current meter becomes difficult. Then the float method is used. This is the most simple and economic method. In this method, surface velocities are estimated. For the measurement of velocities, three sections are marked across a straight and uniform reach of the channel. The distance between the sections is 100 to 200 meters in case of large rivers and 15 to 30 meters in case of small canals. The float is allowed to drift with the current after its release at a convenient starting line. The length of the float run should not be less than 5 times the width of the channel. The travel time should be around 20 seconds. The time taken by the float to traverse a known distance is measured by the observers on the bank, and the velocity is determined. Instead of surface floats, empty canister properly weighted, sealed, and colored to detect its position are also used. But while calculating, suitable correction factors are to be applied to the measured velocity for the shape, size, and density of the float. The total discharge is obtained by summing the discharges through all the vertical sections, as is done in case of current meters. Since the velocity varies along the vertical, measurement of surface velocity only is not sufficient. Therefore, velocity rods or lassie rods are also used, which measure mean velocity of the rod. The actual depth and velocity measurements take a long time. The discharge may vary from day to day and from season to season. So, for quick and qualitative estimates of changes in discharge, some kind of gauging devices are used. A staff gauge consists of a vertical scale made of wood or usually of enamel iron with graduations in feet or meters divided into decimal parts, attached to bridge pier or other structure. With the help of this gauge, variations in water level are measured with reference to some arbitrary zero datum of the water surface at a station. The height thus registered is called water stage. The manual gauges have to be read frequently to relate the reading to discharge. This is particularly important when the river stage changes rapidly, as during floods. In many situations, float type water stage recorders are generally installed in a reinforced concrete shelter house and stilling well on the side of a bank to get the information at close intervals. In a continuous chart recorder, the motion of a float moves a pen along a long strip chart. Mechanical or electrical clocks move the pen from left to right and can be adjusted to make the observation for a desired time. Periodic measurements of discharge with current meter and simultaneous observations of stage provides the useful calibration curve between discharge and the stage. Such a calibration curve is called a rating curve or stage discharge relation. In mountain torrents with numerous boulders and in small streams, discharge measurements with current meter gauging is difficult. In such conditions, chemical methods are used. In this method, an easily measurable chemical which is not present in the stream or not lost by chemical combination is used, such as common salt, fluorescein dye, or a radioactive material. A team is going for the discharge measurement by a radioactive material in Tones River. Balloons are released, and simultaneously, a volume of the tracer of known concentration is injected instantaneously. Balloons are used to identify the arrival of tracer. Samples are taken on both the banks of the river. These samples are taken into the laboratory where on concentration analyzer samples are analyzed and then by calculation discharge is determined. The main disadvantage of the dilution method is the difficulty in determining the section at which complete mixing of the tracer has taken place without loss of the tracer. For small discharges in streams, channels, canals, tube wells, and laboratory models, flow measurements can be made with gauging installations, which works on hydraulic principles. These structures are weirs or flumes. The weirs can be notches of various shapes, rectangular, trapezoidal, and triangular or V-notch. The angle of V-notch can have any suitable value, though the common value is 90 degrees. These are thin plate weirs, and the plane of the notch is perpendicular to the direction of flow. From hydraulic principles, formulae have been developed relating discharge and the head over the crest. For rectangular and sharp crested weirs, the discharge is directly proportional to the hydraulic head raised to the power of 1.5 and to the length of the notch. Hydraulic head is measured by pitot gauge. For V-notch, the discharge is proportional to the hydraulic head raised to the power of 2.5. However, for reliable results, some precautions are to be taken in the installation of weirs. The approach channel should be rectangular with smooth vertical walls. The edge of the notch should be sharp and rigid and made of non-corrosive material. The head of the water should not be measured too close to the notch. In this program, a number of methods have been discussed for discharge measurements. Accurate measurements of discharge over a period of time are also required for building permanent hydraulic structures such as spillways, dams, barrages and bridges. We are sure that you will appreciate the need for accuracy in discharge measurements.